Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. The new synthesis of fatty acids. In humans, fatty acid synthesis occurs primarily in liver and lactating mammary glands, and to a lesser extent in adipose tissues and kidney. Process incorporates carbons from acetyl-CoA into growing fatty acid chains utilizing ATP and reduce NADPH plus H. This slide shows the three phases, activation, elongation, included condensation reactions, three reactions, first reduction, second dehydration, then third reduction, continuation reactions, and termination. So before we start all these fatty acid biosynthesis, we should note that the steps of how the fatty acid synthesis begins. Steps of fatty acids synthesis. A. Production of cytosolic acetyl-CoA. We know that normally the acetyl-CoA produced by the oxidation of fatty acids in mitochondrial matrix. Fatty acid oxidize in mitochondria, fatty acid synthesize in cytosol. During oxidation in mitochondria, after oxidation in mitochondria, acetyl-CoA produced, coenzyme A of acetyl-CoA unable to translocate from mitochondrial matrix to cytosol. So this acetyl-CoA, first condensed in mitochondria, how it brought out, translocated from mitochondria to cytosol, first it condensed with oxaloacetate by citrate synthase enzyme to convert into citrate. Now citrate able to translocate from mitochondrial matrix to cytosol. In cytosol, citrate cleavage split to give oxaloacetate and acetyl-CoA. This acetyl-CoA, by the enzyme citrate lyase, by the expenditure of ATP into ADP and inorganic phosphate. Now this acetyl-CoA, which synthesized after the hydrolysis, after the cleavage of citrate into oxaloacetate and acetyl-CoA. Now this acetyl-CoA is ready to synthesize fatty acids in cytosol. Another picture shows the same conversion of same translocation of the citrate into cytosol, and it again cleavage into oxaloacetate and produce a cytosolic acetyl-CoA. We know that how the citrate coenzyme A part is not able to translocate from mitochondrial matrix, so that is why coenzyme acetyl-CoA condense with oxaloacetate and mitochondria to make a citrate. The citrate ready to translocate, brought out from mitochondria, citrate now it's split by the help of the enzyme citrate lyase to give oxaloacetate and cytosolic acetyl-CoA. Now, carboxylation. Step B, carboxylation of acetyl-CoA to form malonyl-CoA. Production of acetyl-CoA into malonyl-CoA is the regulatory step of fatty acid biosynthesis. And this step is catalyzed by a regulatory enzyme acetyl-CoA carboxylase. Acetyl-CoA carboxylase is the regulatory enzyme of this fatty acid biosynthesis, regulated to convert acetyl-CoA into malonyl-CoA. Reactions, carboxylation occurs, so the biotin acts as a coenzyme, biotin involved to fix the carbon dioxide, added carbon dioxide and the active carbon of acetyl-CoA to convert them into malonyl-CoA. Now, how this enzyme acetyl-CoA, regulatory enzyme acetyl-CoA carboxylase is regulated, Number one, short-term regulation of acetyl-CoA. First mechanism of short-term regulation of acetyl-CoA. Carboxylation is the regulated step of the fatty acid synthesis. The inactive form of acetyl-CoA carboxylase, look at the first mechanism of short-term regulation, the inactive form of acetyl-CoA carboxylases, they consist of a protomers. They are inactive, and each protomers consists of a four subunits. the enzyme undergoes activation by citrate. As well as this enzyme, acetyl-CoA carboxylase is activated by citrate and inhibited by more concentration of malonyl-CoA and pimethyl-CoA. Citrate causes the polymerization of these inactive protamers into active protamers, and it ready to synthesize fatty acids. Now, another second mechanism of a short-term regulation. This is reversible phosphorylation. In the presence of epinephrine and glucagon, the enzyme with phosphorylated and therefore inactivates the acetyl-CoA carboxylases. This slide actually shows that the insulin promotes the fatty acid synthesis via the decarboxylation by the enzyme protein phosphatases. Acetyl-CoA carboxylases becomes activated in decarboxylated form and becomes inactivated in dephosphorylated form and becomes inactive in phosphorylated form. Phosphorylation, whenever the body not required any more synthesis of fatty acids, glucagon and epinephrine activates protein kinase A, and this protein kinase A keeps phosphorylating this enzyme and make them inactive, and results in fatty acid synthesis drops. Insulin, release of insulin, especially in welfare state, they promotes the dephosphorylation by the help of the enzyme protein phosphatases and make this acetyl-CoA carboxylase active. And after activation of acetyl-CoA carboxylase, is able to activate, able to convert acetyl-CoA into malonyl-CoA. Now, the long-term regulation of acetyl-CoA carboxylase. We know that this regulatory enzyme acetyl-CoA carboxylase, its synthesis becomes more in case of a prolonged consumption of high carbohydrates and fat-free diet. Agar fat-free diet le, high carbohydrates diet link that increase the synthesis of this regulatory enzyme acetyl-CoA carboxylase. Increased fat diet or fasting reduce the synthesis of acetyl-CoA carboxylase. Now look at this slide. This slide shows the mechanism of action, that how did carboxylation take place during how the carboxylation occurs in acetyl-CoA to become a malonyl-CoA. We know that biotin acts as biotin, vitamin, acts as a biotin, a B-complex vitamin, it acts as a cofactors for carboxylation. Biotin involved to fix carbon dioxide on one side, and biotin attached with the lysine residues of the carboxylase ions to make a carboxy biotin. Biotin, ek side pe carbon dioxide ko fix karte hai, aur biotin, on the other hand, the biotin attach with the lysine residues of this regulatory enzyme acetyl-CoA carboxylase to make a carboxy biotin. This carboxy biotin able to convert the acetyl-CoA into malonyl-CoA after fixing carbon dioxide. Another slide shows the same reactions. Biotin carrier proteins, we know that biotin defects carbon dioxide, and this carbon dioxide they attach with the active carbon of this acetyl-CoA by the help of the enzyme acetyl-CoA transcarboxylase. So this biotin they attach on these attach with the lysine residues of this acetyl-CoA transcarboxylase or acetyl-CoA carboxylase. Once the carbon dioxide they attach with the active carbon of this acetyl-CoA, they become dissociated from this from the part of the enzyme and convert the acetyl-CoA into malonyl-CoA. Once the acetyl-CoA converted into malonyl-CoA, the rest of the reactions of fatty acid biosynthesis occur in multi-complex enzymes called fatty acid synthase. Fatty acid synthase, a multi-complex enzyme. Let's discuss the details about the structural details about the fatty acid synthase enzyme. Dimers of two polypeptides consist have a 240 kilodaltons molecular weight. 240 kilodaltons. Each polypeptide chains consist of domains that represent the seven quadratic plus integral acyl that represents the six quadratic centers and represent integral acyl carrier proteins, ACP molecule. A multi-complex enzyme made up of ellipsoidal dimers arranged in a head-to-tail fashion. So these two dimers, identical polypeptide monomeric unit, monomer 1, monomeric unit 2, and they arrange in a head-to-tail fashion. Each monomeric unit contains six enzymes and an ACP molecule. So these enzymes, following is the order of the enzyme from end to end in each monomeric unit. Monomeric units में enzymes का order, enzymes की arrangement कुछ इस तरह होगी. 3 ketoacyl synthase condensing enzyme have the active site cysteine sulfide group. एक इसके पास cysteine sulfide, ketoacyl synthase के पास एक active site होती है, what we call the cysteine sulfidyl group. Then acyl transferases, enol reductase, 3 hydroxyacyl dehydratase, 3 ketoacyl reductase. ACP stands for acyl carrier protein. The second active site we call the pentothenyl residues that carried by acyl carrier protein. Pentothenyl residues एब्रीवेशन है फोर फॉस्फोपेंटोथीन का, जो कि पेंटोथेनिक एसिड से पेंटोथेनिक एसिड विटामिन B5 से ड्राइव्ड होता है. तो पेंटोथेनाइल रेजिड्यूज को हम फर्दर एब्रीवेट कर देते हैं पेन रेजिड्यूज के साथ. सो डेट पेन सल्फाइडल ग्रुप दे बिकम द एक्टिव साइट्स, दे अटैच विद द एसाइल कैरियर प्रोटीन्स एंड द लास्ट डोमेन और द एंजाइम थायोएस्टरेज. Slide shows the structure of coenzyme A. This acyl carrier protein, they further attach with the 4-phosphopentothene is the active site which attach with the acyl carrier protein. Now fatty acid synthase. From subunits to domains, fatty acid synthase complex they found in bacteria and plants, yeast as well as in vertebrates, right? So these अब कौन सी चीज़ ने कहाँ पे होल्ड होना है. फैटी एसिड, FAS स्टैंड्स फॉर फैटी एसिड सिंथेस कॉम्प्लेक्स. दिस फैटी एसिड सिंथेस कॉम्प्लेक्स दे हैव टू मोनोमेरिक यूनिट्स, मोनोमर 1, मोनोमर 2. मोनोमर 1 में जहाँ पे ये पेंटोथेनाइल सल्फाइडल ग्रुप इसमें सिस्टीन सल्फाइडल ग्रुप के सिस्टीन सल्फाइड मोनोमर 1 में वन के 16 सल्फाइडल ग्रुप अटैच होते हैं, जिस जो कि एक्सेप्टर होगा एसिटाइल कोए का. मोनोमर 2 में की मोनोमर 2 की एक्टिव साइट्स पेंटोथेनाइल सल्फाइडल ग्रुप वेयर द मेलोनाइल कोए बिकम्स एक्टिव इज अटैच. मोनोमर 1 के एक्टिव साइट्स में एसिटाइल कोए एक्सेप्ट होगा. मोनोमर 2 की एक्टिव साइट जो कि पेंटोथेनाइल सल्फाइडल ग्रुप कहलाती है, इस पे मेलोनाइल कोए की अटैचमेंट होगी. वंस द एसिटाइल को अटैच ऑन मोनोमर 1 ऑफ सिस्टीन सल्फाइडल ग्रुप एंड मेलोनाइल को अटैच ऑन द मोनोमर 2 ऑफ द मोनोमर सिस्टीन सल्फाइडल ग्रुप अटैच ऑन द मोनोमर 2 ऑफ द पेंटोथेनाइल सल्फाइडल ग्रुप पे मेलोनाइल को की अटैचमेंट, सिस्टीन सल्फाइडल ग्रुप पे एसिटाइल को की अटैचमेंट, ये जानना जरूरी है. वंस द एसिटाइल को अटैच on the cysteine sulfidyl group and melanyl coe attach pentothenyl sulfidyl group, ab initiation reaction hoga. Initiation reaction mein kya hoga, initiate kaise hoga, acetyl coe se coenzyme a release hoga aur करवाने वाला एंजाइम ट्रांस एसाइलेज को एंजाइम ए रिलीज करवाएगा और एसिटाइल कोए को बना देगा एसिटेट आयंस. इसी तरह से मेलोनाइल कोए से कोएंजाइम ए रिलीज होगा, कोएंजाइम ए रिलीज करने वाला एंजाइम ट्रांस एसाइलेज कहलाएगा. आफ्टर रिलीज ऑफ कोएंजाइम ए मेलोनाइल कोए बिकम्स मेलोनेट. Now, acetate after release of coenzyme A and malonate after release of coenzyme A. Now, they attach with the cysteine sulfidyl group and pentathenyl sulfidyl group. Once, look at the first step, condensation and elimination reaction. Condensation reactions में क्या होगा? Condensation reaction में acetyl coic यहाँ से acetate ion, acetyl coic से जब coenzyme remove हो जाता है, acetate बन जाता है. So this acetate ions they shift towards the malonate ion at the monomer 2. Monomer 2 में ये convert हो जाता है, monomer 1 को ये free कर देता है, monomer 1 becomes free, acetate ions moves from monomer 1 to monomer 2 to make the acetoacetate. ये acetoacetate बन गया. Right after release of four carbon compounds का acetoacetate बन गया after release of carbon dioxide released during condensation between acetate group and malonate group. Acetate group monomer 1 से monomer 2 में shift होने से carbon dioxide की release होगी during condensation and the product is acetoacetate on this. Now this acetoacetate attach with the monomer 2 at pentathenyl residues. Now once the acetoacetate is formed, the rest of the three reactions, first reduction, second act dehydration and third reduction take place at monomer 2. Monomer 1 tab free rahega, monomer 2 mein ab three reactions honge. So look at the second step, wo teen reactions kaun se honge? First a reduction reaction, pehli reduction hone ja rahi hai acetoacetate pe by consuming NADH plus H. NADH plus pehla NADPH plus H consume hoga, add two hydrogen add honge, one hydrogen attach with this oxygen ketonic group of this beta carbon, another with this beta carbon to make a beta hydroxy butyryl, beta hydroxy butyryl ACP, क्योंकि ये pentathenyl residues ACP के साथ अटैच है, तो लिहाजा हम कहेंगे इस प्रोडक्ट को कहेंगे beta hydroxy butyryl ACP. Now this beta hydroxy butyryl ACP में third step dehydration reaction होगी, water की removal होगी, hydroxyl group they remove from beta carbon and hydrogen from alpha carbon to make alpha beta unsaturation. Dehydration के बाद alpha beta unsaturation establish हो जाएगी, unsaturation establish हो जाएगी और product बन जाएगा alpha beta unsaturated butyryl ACP. Now this alpha beta unsaturated butyryl ACP ACP now it further accept two hydrogens from another molecule of NADPH plus H. दूसरी reduction होगी, second reduction take place, fourth step again the reduction take place, दोबारा दो hydrogen add होंगे, hydrogen donate करने वाला NADPH plus H है, NADPH plus H reduces this alpha beta unsaturation to make them a saturated butyryl ACP. Now this four carbon saturated butyryl ACP once it form at monomer 2, now at monomer 2, right, and so this at monomer 2, look at this butyryl group is attached, four carbon saturated butyric acid jo ki is pe bana tha, that now shift from monomer 2 to ab ye monomer banne ke baad ye group four carbon butyric acid ka group monomer 2 से monomer 1 में shift होगा और monomer 2 free हो जाएगा to accommodate a new malonyl CoA. Look at in continuation reaction. Now in continuation reaction, after shifting 4 carbon butyryl butyric acid from monomer 2 to monomer 1, monomer 2 becomes free to accommodate a new malonyl CoA. दोबारा एक नया मेलोनाइल कोए आ जाएगा. नाउ दिस मेलोनाइल कोए अगेन दिस ब्यूटाइल एसीपी अगेन नाउ इट्स रेडी टू शिफ्ट फ्रॉम मोनोमर 1 टू मोनोमर 2 टू मेक अ 6 कार्बन कैप्रोनिक एसिड और इट्स 6 कार्बन पे दोबारा से रिपीटेशन ऑफ रिएक्शन इज रिपीटिंग अगेन एंड अगेन. फर्स्ट रिडक्शन देन डिहाइड्रेशन देन सेकंड रिडक्शन
to elongate the chain until and unless yahi sequence of repetition repeat hoga.
रिपीट होता चले जाएगा अनटिल एंड अनलेस द 16 कार्बन पामेटोइल एसीपी इज फॉर्म्ड एट मोनोमर 2.
वंस द पामेटोइल 16 कार्बन पामेटोइल एसीपी इज फॉर्म्ड नाउ
दिस वन बिकम टर्मिनेटेड टर्मिनेशन द लास्ट स्टेप टर्मिनेशन रिएक्शन इन टर्मिनेशन रिएक्शन पामेटोइल एसीपी 16 कार्बन सैचुरेटेड पामेटोइल एसीपी नाउ इट्स इन able to incorporate molecule of water and release ACP sulfidyl group. And this release of ACP sulfidyl group, we have a palmitic acid.
Keep in mind, palmitic acid
in a dimeric form, the complex jointly synthesized two molecules of palmitic acid.
Dimeric form may complex दो इकट्ठे पामेटिक एसिड को सिंथेसाइज करते हैं बोथ इन मोनोमर 1 एंड मोनोमर 2 बिकॉज ऑल दीज एंजाइम्स इन द सेम सीक्वेंस असेंबल्ड इन मोनोमर 1 एंड मोनोमर 2 इन ये छह डोमेन्स की और एसीपी मॉलिक्यूल के मोनोमर 1 में भी वही असेंबल्ड उसी तरह से ऑर्गेनाइजेशन होती है जिस तरीके से ऑर्गेनाइज होता है जिस तरीके से मोनोमर 2 में ऑर्गेनाइज होते हैं
तो लिहाजा दो पामेटिक एसिड के मॉलिक्यूल्स एट अ टाइम प्रोड्यूस होते हैं एट द एंड ऑफ टर्मिनेशन रिएक्शन टू पामेटिक एसिड यील्ड इन अ डायमेरिक फॉर्म ऑफ मल्टी कॉम्प्लेक्स ऑफ फैटी एसिड सिंथेस असाइनमेंट एनुमेरेट द स्टेप्स ऑफ फैटी एसिड बायोसिंथेसिस हाउ फैटी एसिड बायोसिंथेसिस रेगुलेटेड Give the steps, structural details of fatty acid synthase complex.
That's all about the de novo synthesis of fat.